Hi, good morning. So today we are in the Philippines. Yes, I am home, and actually I've been here for about a week now. It's been a very busy 6 weeks. This is the reason why sometimes it's difficult for me to make a video. As you can hear, those are dogs. Those are my brother's dogs. Anyway, we used to have dogs around this place. But today we're going to talk about street food. And actually here in the Philippines, one of the most popular kinds of street food is what is known as fish balls. Now, fish balls, or what we call in Tagalog, bola bola, is made of, guess what, fish. And they're made into these little balls, minced fish made into little balls. It's a Chinese thing. And then once they're made, they're actually cooked in oil. You fry them. And then there's a saying to it. It's called tusok-tusok the fish balls. So these students, usually the high-end students, you know, they attend these nice universities and schools. They go out to just have their little fix of fish balls. So they get the barbecue stick and then they make tusok-tusok the fish balls, which in Tagalog means to skewer. So they get just the right amount of balls that they wanted to eat for the time being, and then pay the vendor. Probably like in the olden days, it was like 5 centavos a fish ball. I don't know how much it costs these days, but they fill that up with fish balls in the barbecue stick, as I've said, and then they dip that in sauce of probably like vinegar with some chilies or some sort of a sweet sauce, just to provide the contrast. It's a nice delectable dish. It's actually a snack. And today we're going to teach you how to make it. So stay tuned. To make your fish balls, you first need the following ingredients. Here what we have is some fish. What is most advisable is you have to have white fish. White fish can be what they call it, dalagang bukid. Sometimes you can use also dory. But any white fish would do. Of course, it has to be filleted. You have to remove the skin and deboned. Now, you could also buy this easily by getting those ready-made fish fillets that you can get from the corner grocery store. Be sure that they are thawed and ready to use. Next, we have 1 tablespoon of carrots and 1 tablespoon of chopped spring onions. 1/2 cup of cornstarch. Now, you may also use all-purpose flour, but it will be a little bit firmer if you use flour rather than cornstarch. You may also want to use just sort of like half and half combination of cornstarch and flour, as long as it is 1/2 cup. This will result probably in a firmer and somewhat a little bit lighter kind of mixture. And lastly, some salt to taste. Now we have all the ingredients, it's time to proceed to the kitchen and let's cook. First things first, you have to cut your fish fillet in several pieces like so. Next, we are going to combine all ingredients in a bowl. And using a medium speed, we're going to mix and combine all ingredients very well until it achieves a very uniform consistency. While mixing at medium speed, you would notice that the ingredients would be thrown off at the sides. So once in a while, you should stop the mixer and using a small spatula, center all the ingredients near the beaters. A very nice trick is to position a small spatula at the very inner surface of the bowl as it spins. Scraping the mixture, it automatically falls into the beaters, mincing the fish into a very fine paste. After several seconds, one notices that not only is the fish minced finely, but the resultant paste is light enough to be beaten, incorporating fine pockets of air into the mixture. Now, this is important as it results in a product that would puff when fried later. After a minute or so of beating, it is time to stop the mixer and feel the resulting fish dough. It should be sticky and pasty to feel. Light, it is delicate to handle, but would form a ball when scooped using a small spoon. And judging from the feel of this dough, it seems that the dough is now ready for use. To avoid the dough sticking on your hands, oil your palms with cooking oil. Now, this is important because the sticky fish mixture would create a big mess if you skip this step. And with a ready pot of boiling water,
Handle a palmful of the dough mixture with one hand and squeeze a bit to release a small portion, and with your other hand holding a spoon that would scoop the dough, dropping it in the water as it cooks. The fish balls would take about a minute or so to cook, and once done, remove them from the boiling water using a small colander. Do the same for the remaining amount of the fish mixture. The fish balls can be kept in a small container and refrigerated. So now it's time to fry our fish balls. With shallow hot oil in a pan, fry several pieces at a time, allowing the oil to maintain its temperature. If you have put too much, just wait for the oil temperature to rise again. You will notice that as the fish balls are fried, they pop up and maintain a ball. This is the effect of beating the fish mixture earlier with the mixer. You may choose to fry the fish balls to a crisp. But if you want to cook the fish balls until it reaches a partially caramelized stage, that is likewise okay. A few minutes later, it's time to make tusok-tusok the fish balls using a bamboo kebab stick. Pierce each piece until all are caught with it. Serve the fish balls with a dipping sauce on the side. In this case, it's a mixture of hot chilies with vinegar, which gives a hot sour contrast to the brininess of the fish. Traditionally, there is also a sweet sauce made with a mixture of brown sugar, salt, soy sauce in water, thickened with breadcrumbs or flour, and this gives a sweet contrast to the fish. And eating each piece by popping them whole in your mouth, it's time to compliment the chef and say, pagkatakam-takam, napakasarap!